गुड मॉर्निंग एंड जय हिंद स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम कंचन, योर इंग्लिश टीचर. दिस टाइम आई हैव टेकन द चैप्टर अ लेटर टू गॉड फ्रॉम द बुक फर्स्ट फ्लाइट. सो दिस बुक विल बी फॉर योर एनुअल एग्जाम, फॉर योर एनुअल टर्म एंड देयर फॉर योर सेकेंड टर्म. सो देयर आई जस्ट स्पीक, आई एम गिविंग एक्सप्लेनेशन. दे से फेथ कैन मूव माउंटेन्स. दिस इज द होल सोल मीन्स यू कैन से मेन आइडिया ऑफ दिस स्टोरी दैट People say that if you have faith in anything, you can move even mountains. So, but what should we put our faith in? This is the question this story delicately poses. So, in this story, we will see how a man's faith in his own belief, in his own thought, has made him to be successful, and anyhow he was able to sort out problem. So here activity is about, because today if you want to send money to anyone, we can use Paytm, we can use many apps to send money. But in olden times, money order was their way when someone wanted to send money. So it was through money order. Now here it is activity how to fill money order form, and then how to be the information given. Now it is here money order form, to whom should be given and who is giving about that. So let's start the story. The house, the only one in the entire valley, sat on the crest of a low hill. From this height one could see the river and the field of ripe corn dotted with the flowers that always promised a good harvest. A farmer was there, and his house was in the valley, and it was on the crest of a low hill, and from there anyone could see the whole valley and fields, flowers, and his field was of cornfield, and it was of ripe cornfield and flowers, like they were looking like flowers. So it was so good crop that anyone could believe and have thought that it was a good harvest, means profit was there. The only thing the earth needed was a little rain there. Downpour means a little showering, little rain throughout the morning. Lencho, and the farmer's name was Lencho, who knew his fields immediately. His fields had done nothing else but see the sky towards. Then when he saw dark clouds in the sky from the northeast, he was very happy because his fields were needed a little showering. Now we are really going to get some water, women. And the woman who was preparing supper and his wife told yes, God willing. The older boys were working in the field while the smaller ones were playing near the house, until the woman called to them, come for dinner. So it was their house activities, and it was during the meal that, as Lencho has predicted, big crops of rain began to fall in the northeast. Huge mountains of clouds were there approaching, and the air was fresh and sweet. The man went out because he was very happy, and he was pleased, he was happy, the rain on his body. And then he exclaimed with joy, there are not raindrops falling from the sky. And he told those raindrops as coins. Big raindrops are just like 10 cent and little ones like fives. So here, with a satisfied expression, he regarded the field of ripe corn with flowers draped in a curtain of rain. But suddenly a strong wind began to blow, and along with the rain hailstones began to fall, and it was a very bad thing for his crop. These truly did resemble new silver coins. The boys exposing means icing was there, and it was like frozen pearls. It's really getting bad now, and he became sad that time, and he exclaimed with sorrow, I hope it passes quickly. And he hoped that it will be passed quickly, but it didn't pass. And it was raining, it was icing, and the field was white due to ice, and it was covered with, as it was covered with salt. Then not a leaf remained on the trees. The corn was totally destroyed due to icing, and the flowers were gone from the plants. Lencho's soul was filled with sadness. He became very sad. A plague of locusts. So locust is an insect which fly in big swarms and they destroy the crops. So here he became sad, and he had no hope of about his crop to be left. The hail has left nothing, and that night was a sorrowful one. All our work for nothing, and there is no one who can help us. We will all go hungry this year. Means Lencho was very upset, and he was hopeless also. But in the hearts of all who lived in the solitary, one believed that, believe in God. Don't be so upset. Even though this seems like a total loss, remember, no one will die of dies of hunger. That's why they say no one dies of hunger. Only one believe that God will help us. And Lencho thought only one hope, the help of God, whose eyes, as he had been instructed, everything Lencho was like an axe. So here, simile is here. He was doing hard work like an ox, working like an elephant in the field, but still he knew how to write. Then he went to the post office to write a letter to God. So he wrote, "If you don't help me, my family, and I will go hungry this year. I need 100 pesos in order to sow my field again. Please, God, help me." He wrote to God on the envelope, put the letter inside, and posted it. One of the employees, who was a postman, and he saw that, he was surprised that a letter was there to God. And then the postmaster was a fat, amiable means friendly person was that. And then he saw, and then he thought, ki what a will of this man, what a faith of this man, that he believes in God. And so he thought that I will not shake his faith in God. So he decided that he will give some money, and also he said to his colleagues, to employees, to collect money to just for cooperation, so that he could give to Lencho. And he did that. He collected money. Also he had given part of his salary, and then he had put in that envelope, and it posted to Lencho. Then the following Sunday, Lencho came a bit earlier than usual to ask if there was a letter. Then Lencho got a letter, and then when he counted the money, such was his confidence. But he was not pleased getting money. He was angry. Lencho was not happy because it was not 100 pesos. Whatever the money he had got, it was less than 100 pesos. Lencho went up to the window to ask for paper and ink on the public writing table, and he wrote with much wrinkling of his brow, caused by the effort he had to express his ideas. When he finished, he went to the window to buy a stamp, and then he had written in his letter, "God, of the money that I asked to for, only 70 pesos reached me. Then send me the rest of the money, since I need it very much, but don't send it to me through the mail, because the post office employees are a bunch of crooks." So yaha crooks means either matlab dishonest. So here about Lencho, because postmaster had helped him, it was not actually money was not sent actually by God, but by the postmaster, and with the help of his employees, his colleagues. But Lencho was blaming. So this is the story. Okay, students, thank you, and Jai Hind.